ferry with one only one old nag to ride.
Now, Rufus, how in the world did we get into this mess? Here we are out here lost in the dark and night, riding double on this dumb old horse of yours.
All right, tell me about it, Clyde. I'm along on the back of this thing. Hey, it burns me up every time I think about you just giving your horse go out and scuffy.
Well, seemed like the right thing to do at the time. I mean, you know, she had tucked us in and fed us all in groceries and, you know, it's a good time and whatever.
Bull riding, steer roping, bronco busting cowboy that ever hit these parts. big talk there, Clyde. But can't you shoot?
Can I shoot? Shoot, Dr. Shoot. You don't believe it? You just step right up here to the edge of this corral, and I will give you a lesson in marksmanship.
You couldn't give me a lesson in long-distance spitting.
Oh, that's so. Well.
Anything you can do, I can do better. I can do anything better than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
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 I can go greater, sooner or later, I'm greater than you.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am. Yes, I am. I can shoot a partridge with a single cartridge.
I can get a sparrow with a bow and arrow.
I can live on bread and cheese.
And only on that. So can a rat.
Any note you can sing, I can sing higher.
I can sing any note higher than you.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
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 No, you can.
Yes, I can. Anything you can buy, I can buy cheaper. I can buy anything cheaper than you.
50 cents.
40 cents.
30 cents.
20 cents.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
Anything you can say, I can say softer.
I can say anything softer than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
I can eat a turkey plus a pound of jerky.
I can eat it quicker and get even sicker.
I can move on without the seven if you say.
And without getting caught?
What?
You crook.
Any note you can hold, I can hold longer.
I can hold any note longer than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can. Yes, I can.
No, you can.
I can.
Yes, you can.
Anything you can wear, I can wear better. In what you wear, I look better than you.
In my hat?
In your coat.
In your shoe? I can say faster.
I can say anything faster than you.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can.
Yes, I can.
Okay.
Yes, I can.
Yes,
I can. Yes,
I can.
I can.
I can jump a hurdle.
I can wear a girdle.
I can grab a sweater.
I can fill a dinner.
I can do most anything.
Can you make a pie? Neither can I.
Anything you can say, I can say sweeter.
I can say anything sweeter than you.
Oh, you can.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't.
Yes, I can.
No, you can't, can't, can't.
Yes, I can, can, can.
No.
Sit down here by the fire with us. Yep, we got a buzz again. Well, fellas, let's see if these things are in tune. We're going to do a little bit of Sally Goodwin, Mr. Bob Treese.
Little man's having a tough time, isn't he? Y'all do know that Larry is from Texas. Of course, that's really where a lot of the Wild West started, Longhorns and all that. Of course, y'all remember about 4 or 5 years ago, Texas was wanting Arkansas water. It came up before the legislature. And then have y'all noticed going around here, has he told you about his grandbaby? You know how Texas can really carry on? Somebody said if they suck as good as they blow, one each line flood them to death down there. Out of tune, Mac. T for Texas, T for Tennessee. T for Texas, T for Tennessee. And T for them, a good gal and made a wreck out of me.
Oh,
Doc Linkler to send kids to do the darndest things. I'd like to do a song that, as I said last night, I don't know how many of you have caught it on television, but there's a video out of Gene Autry. I didn't really realize till I had seen it. I don't have it, but the Cowboys, Gene Autry, Roy Rogers, Tom Mix, David, can you name a few of them? You's old enough to see the Cowboy shows.
Yeah.
They sent Gene Autry wherever he went. And we thank Garth Brooks and some of the others command the crowd, but they said Gene Autry, whenever he went to a town, it was like a 4th of July parade. The streets were full, and he really commanded a crowd. And here's a song outside of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, probably one of his most popular. I'm back in the saddle again. I'll fear a friend is a friend. Where the longhorn cattle feed on the lonely gypsum weed. I'm back in the saddle again.
Thank you. and the world is silhouetted against the sky.
Please.
cowboys left their families and sweethearts behind to live a rugged, tough life out on the prairie for only $25 to $40 a month. The songs reflect themes of the separation of lovers and the obsession of dying.
Thank you.
chuck wagon carrying food and other necessary items, with a cook at the reins broke trail, followed by the horse wrangler and his horses. Then came the cattle strung out over a mile or more. At the point or head of the braid, two riders kept the cattle on target. Others guarded the flank, and two more rode drag in the rear to keep things moving. In 1866 alone, over 250,000 head of cattle were driven north toward the railroads. This was only the beginning. In the next 20 years, a total of 6 million head would follow. The cowboy often sang to the cattle to keep them calm.
Oh, the moon was as bright as a reed.
You ain't getting nowhere, and you're losing your share. You must have gone crazy out there. Tells me last night I run into Jenny. She's married and has a good life. Oh, you sure miss the track when you never come back. She's a perfect professional's wife. She asked me, why do you cry for his money? Why does he go for champagne? He ain't getting nowhere, and he's losing his share. He must have gone crazy out there. But then she's never seen the northern lights, never seen a hawk on a wing, never seen spring at the great divide, never heard old Camp Cookie sing. So I read up the last of my letter, tore off the stamp for old Jim. When Billy came out to relieve me, he just looked at my letter and grinned. He said, why do we ride for the money? Why do we vote for short pay? We ain't getting nowhere, and we're losing our share. We all must be crazy out here. Yes, we all must be crazy out here.
Citizens fled indoors while cowboys roamed the streets firing their six-shooters. Just as recklessly, they spent their hard-earned wages in saloons and the like. Seldom did a group of cowboys leave these cow towns without contributing to the population of Boot Hill. Indeed, this was a daring and rugged way of life for all concerned. Meanwhile, in the East, readers eagerly devour embellished accounts written in dime novels about gunfighters, town marshals, and cowboys of the Wild West.
That old Indian, I was in check with him. I was talking to Dan Stokes before the program. He was talking about that rough community he grew up in out there, you know, around the Rose and Clarks and right next to the Goins neighborhood. And I bet that old Indian lives that close, because a couple of years ago, Dan, of course, has a bunch of cows. And he was putting up his hay crop. He had a real good hay crop. Boy, he had up more hay than he'd ever had before. But he got to thinking, you know, and he told Dan, he said, well, run over to that old Indian and ask him how the winter's going to be. So Danny went over there and talked to this old Indian. He said, it's going to be much rough winter. So Danny came back and told Dan, he said, well, I better put up a little more hay. Boy, got out, you know, put up some more hay, and had a lot more than they'd ever had before. So, yeah, Danny go back over and ask that old Indian. He said,
Well, what kind of winter are we going to have? This old Indian said, much snow, much cold, bad, bad winter. So Danny went back and told Dan. He got to thinking about it, so he put up some more hay. And boy, he had over twice as much as he'd ever had before. So Danny went back over there again, you know, asked this old Indian, said, well, now, what do you think about the winter? Oh, blizzards, much cold, much ice, much storm. Little Danny said, well, how do you know? He said, well, I've been watching that white man put up his hay.
Ghost riders in the sky.
unwritten set of rules that came to be known collectively as the Code of the West. It was a sort of frontier version of the Golden Rule. A cattleman fed a visitor because he might himself be far away the next month. He asked no questions of a stranger because he might have preferred not to have his own affairs pried into. When men felt threatened, the code gave him the right to set up vigilance committees, whose members acted as sheriffs, prosecutors, judges, and executioners, dispensing justice on the spot. If no vigilante were available for the job, he took the task into his own hands.
Open for burial.
central figure of the cattle kingdom as it came to be known was in fact the cowboy. He became the legendary figure of his environment which had spawned his unusual profession. He was glorified in song and later by cinema, radio, and TV. His legs were bowed from the long duration astride his horse. His eyes permanently fixed in a squint due to the sun's glare. His skin was dark and tough like leather. He was courageous and self-reliant. Even his attire was functional yet often colorful. Chaps of leather for protection from the brush and bramble. High-heeled boots to catch the stirrups. Spurs to prod and guide the horse when his hands were otherwise busy. Gloves to protect his hands. A handkerchief tied around his neck to pull over his face during dust storms. And a 10-gallon hat to shade his eyes. Everything he did, his demeanor, movement, and actions were designed to fit his job.
Hey, Grandpa.
Mm-hmm.
I just seen you sitting over yawning. Did you forget what it was to have a little one wake you up in the middle of the day?
I know, wake me up.
And he is.
That you're a cowgirl too.
We see by our outfits that we are both cow people. If you get an outfit, you can be a cow person too.
Till the great divide, I wanna hear
Crossing of the railroads came farmers and settlers, barbed wire fencing, and finally the competition with sheep, thus bringing to close one of the most colorful, glorified, and romanticized periods of our nation's history.
Thank you. Grandpa, I've changed my mind. I don't want to be a cow when I grow up. I want to be a lawyer or a doctor.
Well, I'll be proud of you, whatever you are.
But, Grandpa, I like to play cowboys. Let's both go and get to the roundup.
Is Mary Jones Hill here tonight? Well, she doesn't have. Well, y'all all take a bow, all the entertainers. As they take a bow, y'all look at our backdrop tonight. I think it's exceptional. We've certainly enjoyed putting this on for you. Did you enjoy it? You made us feel like you did, and we hope to do it again next year. And until we see you down at the old corral, we'll just say,
Tim.